In Valorant, everyone has some good habits and some bad habits. And one of the most common bad habits is reloading after every kill. I also struggle with this problem. So today, after you guys challenged me, I am not allowed to reload. In fact, I will even bind my R button with dropping my gun. So if I press reload, I will lose my weapon. However, I can pick up guns from the ground. Last episode, we ended up in gold 2, so let's see if we can uprank without reloading. Hello, everyone. So in the first round, Jet pushed mid. Here, I waited till I heard her reloading. And when I heard the reload, I went aggressive to get the kill. And I accidentally dropped my gun.
Yo, you blocked me. Ah, that's bad. Oh no, I dropped my gun. Yes. Okay.
Yes, this is gonna be a hard day. Anyway, during the bonus round, I saw that all the enemies were in B main. When you get information like that, don't be afraid to use it. This is the reason why I pushed behind the enemies and got some nice kills.
Did you hear that? Well, one in the garage.
Last player standing.
Come on, push me. Push me. Come at me, 12 bullets. Ay.
This is for all the Sage mains out there. When a main is smoked, you can use your wall behind the smoke and maybe you can get some sneaky kills on Mr. Lowlander, for example.
Yo, oh, I did not expect that. The shooting together with the... Oh no, I can't reload, I forgot.
Yeah, luckily I didn't have to shoot that round. One rule of thumb that I always use with Jet is that if I'm in a battle and I get hit once, I will immediately dash away. And sometimes you'll get a lucky kill.
Oh, okay, last bullet.
Another tip, when you hold mid on ascent, don't stand in the open like me. Stand a little bit more to the right so only the people from middle can see you, or a little bit more to the left so only the people from short can see you. Otherwise, this will happen.
Beam! Come at me! Not you, the other one. Oh my.
But anyway, in the end, we won the game.
Let's see, we did not get the MVP and we got 23 RR. Let's go to the next one.
Hello, everyone. So in the second game, we played KO. We lost the first three rounds, but in the fourth round, it was a 1v1. And we all know the basics of a 1v1 in post plant. Just save time and you will win the round easy peasy. Here's a very nice trick you can use with any agent with a Molotov. When you are pushing B, throw your molly to the right of the back of sight. The enemies will have to peek left and easy kill for you.
That's OP, man. That trick, I love it.
After that kill, I slowly shot all my bullets away till I had one left.
4 bullets, all you need. All you need 4 bullets in that thing. Oh, last bullet.
I think I say this every episode, but lurking is very good, my friends. The reason why I talk about lurking so much is because personally, I get a lot of kills this way. So don't be afraid to leave your team sometimes and go sneaky peeky like. Just like I did in this round.
Haha, lurk OP, my friend. So I don't know. Never mind. Got him.
Or alternatively, you can just rush with your team. Also very good.
Oh, he's on top. Oh,
one enemy remaining.
Last one behind.
Also, a nice KO flash is just throwing it against the pyramid. It will bounce very nicely.
Flashbang. He's low. One hit. Yay, we got him.
When there's a Viper on B side, you don't have to go left immediately. You can also take one left later. This way you can get behind the enemy. However, if there's another one on backside, don't use this trick. In this round, there was one on backside, but luckily Sky was not very good.
OP. 7 bullets.
Another nice thing about this challenge is that you sometimes have to go for those one taps. So this is a cool challenge to force yourself practice those. And again, lurking OP, my friends.
Oh, he's there. Okay, good job.
When you see smokes that aren't placed properly, try to work around them. Enemies won't expect that you can see them and you can get some nice kills.
Oh, that's one. I'm blind now.
Got him.
Boom. 13 bullets.
One enemy
okay. Ah, we got 2, 3, 4. Huh?
You got 3 over there, Mr. Lowlander. Yes, I know it's hard to count.
Beam. Destroy.
I can do this all day. Last player
okay. Also, even on the defending side, don't be afraid to push sometimes. Sometimes it will work out.
Okay. Oh, wait. Oh, huh? I thought I would reload it.
Yeah, Lowlander was a bit confused over there, but after this kill... We sadly lost the game.
Let's see, we did cut the MVP. Let's go to the next one.
Hello, everyone.
When you see a Sage ball like this, always check the right corner and easy attack helicopter.
Headshot him. Attack helicopter! Oh no, I cannot reload.
After you dash in aggressively with jet and make a kill, wait with peeking till your team follows you. Here I didn't wait, so it was a 1 versus 2 and I lost the duel.
Two on side.
Aww, thought you'd try harder.
We got him.
With jet, the updraft and dash combo is very OP if you have a shotgun like a judge. Easy kills for
Here
me.
Here we go! That's how we do it, very good.
I also want to make clear again, pushing on the defending side is not always bad. Sometimes it works out.
Nice. Alright, we got him.
For the OG viewers of this channel, you know that I love doing the teleport trick. But there's one reason why it might wouldn't work out. And that is if a teammate throws something through the teleporter first. This way the teleport doors will be already opened and the enemies might be in the teleporter. In this round, I was just in time.
Oh, he messes up my teleport trick. Oh no, never mind. Teleport trick always works. Oh, no bullets.
However, in this round, I was too late. So be careful, my friends.
Yes, oh, why did I do it?
But anyway, in the end, we won the game. Easy peasy.
We did not get the MVP and we got 22 RR. Nice, let's go to the next game.
The game after that, we played race and we got a nice attack helicopter.
Yeah, sky's there.
One enemy remaining.
Attack helicopter!
But we sadly lost the game. After that, Killjoy.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
So in the first round, we decided to move towards B. This turret over here is nice to catch people flanking.
Oh yeah, I can't reload, I forgot.
After that kill, we rotated towards A. In this crossfire, I peeked a little bit too early.
Oh no.
But we still won the round, luckily. When you make a nice kill, always be careful because there might be a second enemy going for the refrag. I didn't pay attention over here.
One more.
Also, OP jet trick for the jet mains. It went so fast, man, I couldn't shoot in time.
You want to play? Let's play.
Oh, that's a sneaky. Let's take an operator. You only need 5 bullets, right?
In for fuck.
Yes!
Come in.
I'm coming.
Don't stand where I'm standing because you don't have a way out after you miss a shot. And I missed my shot. Oopsie.
No, I missed.
Anyway, here's a nice killjoy setup that almost works every time when the enemies are trying to push. Turret on top of the barrels, and then over here, your alarm bot in the middle of 2 nano swarms. When your alarm bot goes off, activate your nano swarms and easy kills for you. One of the reasons why this is especially good is because it's also mentally hurting the enemy. Nobody likes to get killed by nano swarms.
OP setup. 12 bullets. 6 bullets.
One enemy remaining.
Ah.
Here, throwback to the first video of this channel. Place your ultimate in the corner, then go to that tree and do a nice lineup. It's a cool trick, but sadly, it didn't get any kills from me this time.
One enemy remaining.
Under.
Last attempt.
No! What the heck? How did I miss everything? Oh, I'm so bad, sorry.
Whoa, Mr. Lowlander, calm down, my friends. It's just a game.
Whoa. Oh, and I dropped my gun. Oopsie.
And in the end, we luckily won the game. Nice.
Let's see, we did not get the MVP and we promoted. Whoop.
Anyway, this is the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed. Let me know in the comments down below what challenge I should do next. Happy New Year, my friends, and I see you guys in the next one. Peace.